Hey everyone, welcome back for more ExoZero's content. Today's video, I'm going to discuss my first impressions of FC Tupaki's banner. Let's see what improvements are made or were made versus his original form. But before that, if you want to see more ExoZero's content, please hit the subscribe button down below. So here we are with a notice of Fate Core Chance Increase, Extremely Passionate Tupaki Recruit. So Tupaki is, I think, the sixth member of the group, or the seventh, if I can recall. Can no longer count because there are a lot of members of the Banga family, but he is the first of the Banga family which has a blue or a blue Fate Core. So you can recruit hero plus Fate Core with a high probability than premium recruit. So starting October 22 after the maintenance to October 28th, you'll be able to recruit FC Tupaki for about a week. So if you can see his design, it's better than his previous one. He's like a barbarian. He packs a punch with this outfit of his. So let's move on. So he has an attack of 49, defense of 81, health of 389, and combat power of 16,200. So a bit average. And we'll start with his passive. So his original form has thrust as well, but right now with his passive, this includes already the heart strike that every member of the Banga family has. So for level 1, you have decreased 20 attack speed of the target. Level 2, you have decreased 1000 defense of the target. And level 3, decreases 20% damage to all enemies upon activation. So status effects, afflicts target with blind. So afflicts 2000 damage to every turn. This actually is a what do you call this? I can't find the term. This skill is very annoying if you're on the receiving end of the heart strike. So very powerful to be given to his kit. So let's start with his S1. So his S1 is now named Bombardment. So it's more or less the same as his original form. So also requires 1 mana. But the difference is the damage being dealt right now is 150% versus his original form, which is 100%. And his S2, renamed as Axe Bombing, deals 750 damage to 1 enemy. Also, the same required mana cost, but the damage is up from 500 to 750. So it gives him a bit of damage. But what I think you guys are after, aside from the improvements in his kit, would be the Blue Fate Core additional stat bonuses. Because number one, he gives stat bonuses to North 1 Frosty heroes. So if you can see here, there are a lot of good heroes here that we've been using for a long time that would be given stat bonuses, like Shifraken, Valentina, Ramji, Bernadette, Anastasia, Digas, Brooke, Kirina, Lepin, and the others. So in terms of stat bonuses, he could give you a bit of a little increase, not that much. Little increases eventually pile up, so it would eventually contribute to your whole team as well. Let's move on to his chance to get. So Tupaki is a 0.5% chance to summon or to recruit. So earn 1 recruited mileage when you recruit heroes 11 times. And he can be PT pulled for 28 core mileages. So that's actually a lot. It's equivalent to pulling for a gold Fate Core. And also, for his exclusive weapon, so he has Axe Bomber. It's your usual weapon that usually comes with the character. The difference is the equipped character with the specialized weapon gets an additional 300 combat power. So same with summoning for the hero. This is also 0.5% when you pull for this one. So to give you guys my overall thoughts, I think Tupaki is not really a must summon unless you really want the hero. If you want to go all in with this one, it's like going all in for a gold Fate Core. So if you want to just throw in a couple of Zest, it's okay. But I would suggest that you save up your Zest for next week's FC banner drop. I'm not sure because Halloween is near, and I'm sure they'll be dropping a gold Fate Core before Halloween. So I would suggest you save up your Zest for that one. If you really want this banner, and if you really want to add him to your Banga collection, or if you really want the hero itself, try to pull, but do not spend so much Zest. He's not currently in the meta, and I don't think he will give a very big impact in terms of the meta, because there are a lot of other Banga family members that give you more than what Tupaki gives you at the moment, even if with his FC. That concludes my video, guys. So let me know what you think in the comments below. Please give me your insights on if you're going to summon for Tupaki, if you could use him in your current setup, and if you also don't want to summon for him, put it in the comments below. You all stay safe, you all take care of each other, and I'll see you next video. Warden out.